Sir Vijaysai Reddy. Vijaysai Reddy.
Thank you, Vice Chairman, sir. All smaller parties like us are extremely happy with the Vice Chairmans because they are liberal and sympathetic in giving time.
Don't expose.
Smaller parties. Sir, we are very happy to support the bill and I expect a smile from Honorable Law Minister, but I am not finding it. Sir, there are the benefits of the bill are much more than probably one or two infirmities, which I will bring it to the notice of the Honorable Law Minister. Sir, first of all, because of the bill, if passed as a law, because it consists of the expert arbitrators, the quality of expertise will obviously go up. This is a plus point. And the second is cost of arbitration. Cost of arbitration, according to me, because I also faced some arbitrations earlier and it is prohibitively high, because of this, there's every possibility of cost of arbitration is likely to come down, because I expect Honorable Law Minister, while framing the rules, consider framing the rules in this regard. Sir, thirdly, because it will facilitate, this bill will facilitate India becoming a hub for international institutional arbitration, and I expect international companies to come, as is in the case of London and Singapore, they choose India also as a hub of the arbitration. Sir, the last plus point, benefit is burden on the court. As has rightly pointed out by the Honorable Law Minister, when we want arbitrators to be appointed, we need to approach the court, and the court will decide the part on with the mutual consent of the parties. Court will decide the arbitrators, and then it will reduce the time of the courts, and also the burden on the courts will come down. Sir, there are two infirmities which I would like to bring to the notice of the Honorable Law Minister. Sir, the chairman and members, totally seven. Chairman is a judge or retired judge, and seven members. Three are ex officios, and two are from different fields, experts in the arbitration, and another one or two are from the trade end also. All the members, who are appointing this board, it is again the government. I really don't know why the Honorable Law Minister would like to have a control over the in constitution of the board. It could have been independent, as is in the case of London or Singapore. Sir, what I find in the bill is not only financially self-sustaining, but eventually I expect the government also earn money for it makes money and then gives to the government also, sir. And coming to the next bill, Arbitration and Reconciliation Amendment 2019. Only 2 minutes, sir. Sir, again, it's a government empowers to nominate individuals nominated by the central government only. The same point what I have elaborated there, it is seven. I think it is only here, it's only one. Arbitration Council has been introduced as a regulator and has been given broad powers to frame the regulation. This goes against the basic tenets of the arbitration, because if I am a litigant and with the other party, both the litigants, they decide on the arbitrators. They sit and decide on the arbitrators. If they come to some sort of understanding, they go to the court and then file a petition, and the court will ratify it. So in this case, it is slightly different, sir. Whereas the party, that party decides the procedure which are comfortable to them, that objective is lost here. Sir, I draw your attention of the Honorable Law Minister to Section 42A regarding the confidentiality clause. Sir, parties are to maintain confidentiality of arbitral proceedings except during the award implementation and enforcement. My question is, sir, what about the enforcement of interim orders and their implementation? And finally, sir, arbitral tribunals to make award in 12 months is the law that is in force. I really don't understand why the Honorable Law Minister has excluded the international commercial arbitration from the time period. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Reddy, you confined to the time. Not that I was liberal.